To find out right now about how Midyear sounds in 2014. I know he sounds particularly chipper at the moment, but that's because, Midge, you've got a brand new album coming out called Fragile.
I have, and it's been a long, long, long time in the making.
Yeah, something like 10, 12 years?
Yeah, something. Yeah, 10 years too many, I think. that's a long time. Most boy bands I know, if you put all their careers together, it wouldn't last 10 years, so it's crazy, isn't it?
It is a bit crazy. So what's caused this delay? Is it simply because, some artists have writer's block, some people need to be sort of nudged in the ribs to get something out there? What was the cause?
If only I had those excuses. I don't really have an excuse. I mean, I have many reasons as to why it took that long. I became a bit less enamoured with the music industry than I have been for periods of that. I thought that it was a bit redundant, making some new music to put it out there that no one would ever hear, and the industry has changed so much over the last few years. It seems to have focused totally on, signing, the same, because they haven't got the money and the wherewithal to invest in new music, which is a little frightening, to say the least. So I just thought, well, there's no point really. But then I kind of realised that if I didn't finish this and didn't get on with putting something new out, then the mediocrity kind of wins. So I slapped myself in the back of the head and just got on with it and finished it.
And what a mix you've got there. I've been listening to the album in the car over the last two or three days. If I was to sort of sum it up, I would say sort of like atmospheric, almost ambient in a way. Would that be a fair description?
Yeah, I mean, it's something I think I said on the little thing I went out with in the album, trying to describe what it is. I said it was kind of like wearing your musical influences on your sleeve, because there's stuff in there that I recognise that I was kind of listening to when I was a kid. My older brother would play, kind of prog rock albums at home. An essence of that's in there, an essence of early kind of blues or electric guitar playings in there. Mix that together with all the atmospherics that I've always ever been associated with, and you get an idea of what this album is. It's a very kind of growing up record, really. I mean, there's a track on there, an instrumental, that's 7 minutes long. I mean, don't let that put people off, but it's like filmic, it's cinematic, but still very palatable.
I did think when I was listening to Star Crossed, I could see that sort of rolling underneath some credits at the end of a movie.
Well, you'd like to think so. I mean, those things are in the lap of the gods. You know, you're lucky if somebody comes along and hears it and says that would be perfect for my visuals. But I think that this type of music is ideal for that. It's very cinematic.
Vocally, Midge, I was quite surprised with the opening track, because obviously I know I've seen you perform. I saw you perform only the other weekend, and normally there you're belting out the sort of lyrics and the songs, Dancing with Tears in My Eyes, Vienna, etc. But I survived much more subtle.
I think again, it's a matter of people kind of trademark you, and my trademark is the big bombastic chorus, the big vocals, and sometimes when you're making an album, you have to do what you think is right and what you think is interesting. So I played a lot with the vocal treatments, the vocal performances on this. Some of it's sung in a whisper, some of it's really close mic, some of it gets into the big bombastic thing that you'd expect to hear. But weirdly, it all sounds like me, I think. It's still got very much that definable style, that melodic element that I've always kind of had. So I think even if people thought twice, is it, isn't it, there's a good chance that they'll figure out that it's me.
Now, one of my favourite tracks we're going to hear right now, I wonder if you can just tell us a little bit the thought process behind it. I like Let It Rise. That's one of my favourites on the album.
Well, it was a track that I actually worked in conjunction with a German writer, a German musician from a band called Schiller, who specialise in kind of electronics, almost kind of trip-hop electronic stuff. And Christian, the main guy, is a huge fan. And we got together and wrote something for his album, and it came out on his album. But I thought the treatment that he gave it, because he comes from a different genre, a different area of music, was very different from what I would have done with the song. So I started playing with it and gave it my interpretation, and it works incredibly well. I mean, I played it to him, and he absolutely loves it. So again, it's like the idea that you can take one idea and different musicians can pull that idea into completely different areas. So I'm very pleased with that track. Something in the atmosphere.
Radio Devon with Midge's Let It Rise. It's from his forthcoming album called Fragile, out at the beginning of